Hello, futurists. This week I wanted to talk about gene editing, so I recruited the anarcho-primitivist and the transhumanist to give their perspectives on this topic. But before we can have their epic debate, I figured I should give some background information on what gene editing is and how it works. Now, gene editing is a term that can actually refer to a variety of procedures, all of which involve modifying the genetic code of a living creature, thereby modifying its traits and characteristics. The most modern tool we have for gene editing is a technique called CRISPR-Cas9, which you may have already heard about. CRISPR is a system that was actually developed by bacteria to fight off viruses, and it allows DNA to be cut off at specific locations and certain genes removed. Then, those genes can be replaced by other ones. CRISPR is an amazingly precise system. It's been compared to the cut-and-paste function on a computer. We can basically code CRISPR to remove and replace whatever genes we want. Right now, for example, CRISPR could be used to modify basic genetic traits like a person's eye color. It hasn't yet in humans, but it could. And one day, CRISPR might be used to modify more complex traits like a person's intelligence or physical strength. But for that to ever happen, we would first have to pinpoint exactly what genes control those traits, and that's a bit complicated. Furthermore, CRISPR and techniques like it can be used on pretty much any species, plant, animal, or human. Right now, a large percent of the crops that we consume are genetically modified organisms, or GMOs. Furthermore, there are plans to potentially eradicate diseases like malaria by genetically modifying mosquitoes to pass on a trait that would ultimately render them sterile, thereby putting the mosquito population into severe decline. The ethical questions of gene editing plants and animals are interesting ones, but since gene editing is such a huge topic, I'll be focusing on human modification in this video. The main way that gene editing is being used in humans right now is to combat specific genetic diseases in adults. This is generally referred to as gene therapy and has been used to fight diseases like sickle cell anemia and muscular dystrophy, and perhaps even HIV and cancer in the near future. But any genetic modification made to an adult will not be passed down to their children, unless it's the sperm or egg cells that are being edited, which is quite rare. Additionally, my understanding is that gene therapy only targets specific cells, which makes it unlikely that gene editing could ever be used to radically alter the genetic makeup or physical characteristics of an adult human. Thus, gene editing's primary potential comes with editing human embryos. If done correctly, then when an embryo has its genes edited, and then that embryo splits into more cells, and those cells split into more until eventually you have a baby, then every single cell in that baby will have the gene modification made to the original embryo. Plus, when that baby ultimately has children of its own, the genetic modification will be passed down to them as well. Obviously, all these factors make the gene editing of human embryos particularly powerful and particularly controversial. In the near future, people could edit their children to be more resistant to diseases, or they could edit them to be taller, blue-eyed, and more intelligent, allowing for so-called designer babies. In addition, the health risks of editing human embryos are not yet super well known, and doing so could result in unwanted side effects that are also passed down to all the descendants of the edited baby. With all that being said, I still think it's very possible we're heading towards a future where gene editing becomes the norm. And so, I gathered TH2150 and the ANPRIM here today to discuss this very important topic. Specifically, I'd like them to respond to the following question. Is the gene editing of human embryos a good idea? ANPRIM, we'll start with you. Yeah, so I'm terrified by this technology, and I think anyone with a brain should be. We're clearly meddling with things that we should not be meddling with, and the consequences can be disastrous. I mean, whenever we edit someone's genes, we can never be absolutely certain what the health impacts on that person will be, and there can always be unintended medical side effects. And if we're talking about editing embryos, those side effects will be passed down to all future generations. But even more than the direct health risks of a technology like this, I worry that gene editing could be used to further entrench social and class distinctions. The rich and powerful can use gene editing to ensure that their children and that their children's children are more attractive, intelligent, athletic, and healthy than the rest of us. Gene editing can literally create a two-tiered humanity where the edited people are the superiors and the rest of us are inferior. And that's terrifying.
I see. And TH, what are your thoughts?
Well, naturally, I disagree with the Anprim on this one. I think that gene editing is an exciting technology that offers a radically new way to ensure the health and overall well-being of future generations. I think that editing our children to be more resistant to diseases can only be construed as a positive thing. Now, it sounds like the Anprim's main concern is the question of accessibility. But there's no reason to assume that gene editing will be this super expensive technology that's only accessible to the ultra-rich. As we speak, there are so-called biohackers who are editing the genes of different animal species from their own garages. And I think that's really awesome, as long as they do have some training in the ethics and logistics of what they're doing. Now, of course, editing human embryos is a more difficult process and will require a medical professional. But there's no reason that it can't be financially accessible as well, especially if the government were to step in. So the question that I'm interested in discussing is not, should we have gene editing, because I certainly think that we should, but rather, how can we make sure that gene editing is accessible to everyone? Because that's the world that I want to live in. I just want to jump in and say that I think TH is deluding himself if he actually believes that gene editing can be made accessible to everyone in the world. I mean, we're discussing a radically powerful technology that can allow whoever wields it to give their descendants a major genetic advantage. So naturally, those in power are going to want to reserve this technology for themselves and their friends. So they'll find ways to make sure that it's only accessible to themselves, maybe by making it exorbitantly expensive, or perhaps by even lobbying the government to make gene editing illegal just so they can go to their private practitioners and have their children edited off the books while no one else is allowed to. But even if we were living in TH's imaginary utopia where everyone had access to gene editing, well, that's not a world that I would want to live in either. Naturally, there would always be a sizable portion of the population who rejects gene editing for ethical or religious reasons, and their children would be at a severe disadvantage. Additionally, a world with gene editing would be much less diverse. Specifically, I'm thinking about disability. Gene editing as a technology has the potential to wipe out disability entirely. Now, anarcho-primitivism has often been labeled a ableist ideology because we do reject most modern technology, and some of that technology is necessary to give disabled people a high quality of life. And for that reason, I do try to give modern medical technology, the benefit of the doubt. But here we're discussing a modern medical technology that could wipe out disability entirely. And I was curious what people in the disabled community had to say about a technology like that. So I did a little bit of research on TH's laptop, and I found that some disabled people were supportive of gene editing because they didn't want future generations to have the same condition that they do. But many others were critical of such a technology, and I think we all should be. People with disabilities have been around since the beginning of humanity. And if we were to use gene editing to wipe out disability, we would be far more uniform in how we perceive the world, and we would miss out on the perspectives and experiences of people with disabilities. And I don't think that would be a wise move, and it might even be an immoral one.
How would you respond, TH?
Yes, well, it is a difficult question. I will say that I would never want to suggest that we should be using gene editing to achieve some sort of normal genetics in our children, because what is normal? Even among, you know, healthy humans, there's so much genetic diversity that it would be impossible to define certain traits as normal and others as abnormal. So no, I don't think we should ever be using gene editing to strive towards some sort of ill-defined normalcy in future generations. But that being said, I do think that if a child is going to be born with a condition that would objectively decrease their quality of life, and that can be avoided with gene editing, then we should be doing that. That's my stance, at least. And I also wouldn't just stop at preventing disease and disability. I'm in favor of enhancement editing as well. If someone could edit their child to be more intelligent or stronger, then why shouldn't they? It might sound abnormal, but I think it would be really difficult to find an ethical objection to doing this. If you could make your child smarter, let's say, well, that would be a benefit to your child, perhaps a benefit to yourself, and a benefit to the world at large. So, in my eyes, that's the moral thing to do.
I see. And Prim?
You know, I think TH is correct in saying that it would be difficult to find an ethical objection to enhancing your children in the way that he's describing. But I think we need to consider what the social ramifications would be. For thousands of years, pretty much the entire history of humanity, we valued traits in other humans, like intelligence, athletic ability, physical attractiveness, and the like, all of which have at least some basis in a person's genes. Now, if we were to use gene editing to make it such that anyone could be intelligent, anyone could be athletic, anyone could be attractive, would we still value those traits? I think if everyone were athletic, that would no longer be something worth valuing or something to be impressed by. And it's really difficult to imagine a society where we no longer value those things. Now, one could argue that perhaps we shouldn't have been valuing genetic traits in the first place because it's not like the person, you know, had any control over their own genes. And that may be true, but we've been valuing those traits for so long that it's basically human nature, and I think it would be really difficult to predict the social ramifications of completely altering our system of values like that. And for that reason, I think it's best that we leave people's genes up to chance and leave, you know, advanced intelligence, advanced athletic ability as relatively rare traits rather than editing everyone to be the perfect human being. Well, it sounds to me like the Anprim favors the current system where two adults have a baby and that baby's genetic code is sort of a random mix of the parents' genes. And certainly that's the natural system. That's the way that genetic inheritance has worked for millions of years. But just because it's natural doesn't mean that it's moral. This current system has left countless humans with severe disabilities, serious diseases, and many other conditions that make living life burdensome. We humans can now create a more moral system. With gene editing, we can eradicate many of the diseases and disabilities that have plagued humanity throughout its history. The current random chance system doesn't know what is and isn't moral, but we do. And since we now have a technology that can enable us to ensure a happier and healthier future for humanity, it's our responsibility to do so. I'm pretty sure that's where we're heading already, and what's important to me is making sure that gene editing is as safe and accessible as possible. Unfortunately, that is all the time we have for the day, but I want to thank you both for your contributions, and I hope we'll see you again soon. And to those of you watching, please, let us know what you think about gene editing in the comments below. I'm really curious. And you can check the description if you want to learn more. I think that gene editing is a really important topic, perhaps one of the most important of the coming century. And so I would also encourage you to talk about it with your friends and family. Tell them what you've learned and find out what their thoughts on gene editing are too. And as always, make sure you're subscribed and stay tuned for future videos. See you soon.